लेट मी रिकॉर्ड एंड लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन। अगेन वन पर्सन इज मिस्ड, रोनाल्डो, एंड दैट्स फाइन। ओके राइट, सो यू कैन यूज योर मैनेजमेंट स्टूडियो व्हिच इज अ क्लाइंट टू टॉक टू द SQL server. Okay, so we'll connect to the SQL server, and whatever queries you want to write, you can write it and you can execute in the SQL server only. There is a separate session on Management Studio, SQL Server Management Studio. I'll tell you how to use this, how to install it, everything I'm going to explain. Okay, so nothing to worry as of now. Just to show you the SQL servers, I just opened SSMS and connected to one instance. Instance is nothing but one SQL Server software copy. You can call it as a one instance, one SQL instance. Okay, we'll generally use SQL instances, not SQL servers. Okay, sometimes we'll call it as a SQL servers, but sometimes we'll call it as a SQL instances, right? So if you see here, there are three parts in this name. Okay, there are three parts in this name. What are those three parts? Can anyone tell me? In this name, you can see three parts. What are those three parts? Can anyone tell me?
Sir, major version, minor version.
Not like that. There are three parts. Whatever you can see here, highlighted one. What and all you can see here? Forget about the major, minor and all. Server name,
number. Okay. And then user login. That is
very good. Excellent. Okay, so if you see in the server name, there are three parts actually. Okay, first part is server name. This local host is your server name. Or else, let me go like this. What is the computer name? Okay, let me connect. Let me go and browse the computer name. And let me go to the database engine. Let me connect to this desktop. Okay, and connect. So let me disconnect. Okay, so this is your connect button, which you can see a computer symbol. This is your disconnect button. Select the instance, disconnect it. Select the instance, disconnect it. Okay, so you are simply disconnecting. That's it. You are not stopping. Remember, guys, SQL Server should be up and running 24/7. Okay, here, if you have work, you will connect the server. If your work is completed, you will disconnect the server. Guys, tell me, can I directly close the Management Studio, or is there any impact for my SQL Server if I close the Management Studio directly? I need answers from everyone. Can I close the Management Studio directly from here? Or if I close it directly, my SQL instances will be stopped? Tell me, guys, I need answers from everyone. Can I close it directly, or I cannot close it?
We can close it directly.
Yes, we can close, but there will be crash.
Need answers, please. In the chat, if yes, you can type yes. If no, type no. Can I close the Management Studio directly? Right, okay, so let's go with the answers. And Shankar Sayed, okay. Shankar Sayed and Sunil Vijay John, four people, okay. You four are correct. Okay, so the answer is yes. You can close SSMS, guys, at any time. Why? Because in our organization, once you go to the company, you will connect to the servers, you will open SSMS, you will work with it, and what you are going to do? Okay, what you are going to do? Once your work is completed, you will close the SSMS. That's it. Closing SSMS doesn't mean stopping the SQL server. Closing SSMS doesn't mean stopping the SQL server, guys. Okay, closing is different. Stopping SQL servers are different. Okay, so don't think like if you close the SSMS, something happened to your SQL server. Nothing will happen. Work is there, it will be connected. Work is not there, it will be disconnected, or you can close the Management Studio. Guys, 1 minute, guys, I'll be back. Just 1 minute. Right, okay. So in case if you close the management studio, nothing will happen, okay? Again, you can open and again, you can connect to the management studio. So management studio, as discussed, it's just a client to talk to the customer. Customer means your server. Okay, if you have work, you will connect to the management studio, you will connect to the server in the management studio, then you will complete your work. Again, you are going to close the management studio, okay? So there is nothing like if you close the management studio, automatically SQL servers are down, nothing like that, okay? You can close it and you can open it again. You know, once your work is completed, again, you can close it. If you have some work to run the queries and all, to write the queries and all, again, you can open the management studio, you can connect to the servers. But servers can't be stopped, guys. Remember, you cannot stop the servers, okay? You can still stop the servers from management studio also. Right click, okay? There is an option to stop the servers. This you cannot do it. If you stopped it, how can you communicate with the SQL server, right? You cannot communicate with the SQL server, okay? So never, as a DBA, never stop the SQL server. You have to remember this point, very important. If you stop the SQL server, that's it. Okay, that is the last day of your career. Career means your particular job in that particular organization. Okay, so don't stop the SQL server. There are some scenarios where you can stop the SQL server. There are some scenarios where you can restart the SQL server. I'll explain those scenarios, in which scenario we can stop it and which scenario we can restart it. I'll explain those scenarios. But generally, if your work is completed, close the management studio. That's it. Don't stop the SQL servers. Okay, so nothing will happen. The answer is yes, you can close the management studio. Nothing will happen to the SQL server. Okay, so 6 of you are wrong, 4 of you are right. Okay, fine. Right. So this is my management studio, right? So here you can see 3 parts. First part is computer name or server name. You can call it as a server name. Okay, the first part is server name, this part. Desktop BAS28LM. The whole part is your server name. Second part is your bill number. Okay, 15.0.2000.5. This is your bill number, second part. Third part is the user who is connected to this SQL server. Okay, who is connected to the SQL server? If you open Management Studio in your laptop and if you are connected, you will get your name. Okay, if you install SQL Server in your laptop and if you connected, you will get your name. Okay, those who connected, okay, the username you can see here. This is computer name / username. So 3 parts will be there in the server name. First is server name, second part is your bill number, and third part is like username, who connected to the SQL Server. Okay, fine. So we are going to discuss about nothing to discuss the server name and username. Okay, this is very important. 15.0.2000.5. What is this number, guys?
Bill number, sir.
Right. Very good. Okay, so bill number. What is this number? Bill number. So how it is useful for us? Right. So can anyone tell me which version it belongs to?
2019.
Very good. Okay. How, like some people, one or two people answer 2019 immediately. Okay. So how come they answer this 2019? There is no 2019 you can see here, right? But still they are able to answer. Why? Because of this number, bill number. Okay. So bill number contains 4 parts. Okay, you can see here, right? 15 is one part, 0 is another part, 2000 is third part, and 5 is fourth part. Okay, so first is major version, first part is major version, second part is minor version, third part is actual bill number, okay, and fourth part is your revision history. Okay. So major version dot, minor version dot, actual bill number dot, revision history. Okay, if you see here, Okay, so if you install SQL Server 2000, your bill number starts with 8.0. 8.0. I am just mentioning major and minor. I am not mentioning actually. Why? Because a lot of actual bill numbers will be there. To identify the server immediately, just by looking the version or bill number to identify the server, which version of server it is, to identify the server immediately. Okay, so you can use these bill numbers. Where we are going to use these bill numbers to identify the version of the SQL Server immediately by just looking the server name, you can use these bill numbers. And whether your SQL Server is patched or not, you can identify using this bill number. First and important thing is, bill number is helpful to identify the version of the SQL Server. And second thing is, bill number is going to help you or helpful to check whether your SQL Server is updated or not, means patched or not. Patching means updating the SQL Server. Okay, patching means updating your SQL Server. Like regularly you will get updates, right, for PhonePe, GPay, okay, whatever apps you are using, WhatsApp, you are going to get updates regularly, right? Sometimes you have to update it manually, sometimes it will be updated automatically if your phone is connected to the Wi-Fi. Okay, right? So every application updates will be there. So bill number mainly will helpful to find out the version of the SQL Server. Second thing, to find out whether your SQL instance is patched or not. Okay, so how can you find out the version of the SQL Server? By just looking the bill number. Okay, so if you install SQL Server 2000 in your laptop or server, the bill number starts with 8.0. If you install SQL Server 2005, the bill number starts with 9.0. If you install 2008, the bill number starts with 10.0. If you install 2008 R2, bill number starts with 10.50. Only for 2008 R2, you can see 10.50. Okay, only for 2008 R2, you can see the minor version. For all other versions, minor version is 0 only. Okay, if you install 2012, you can see the bill number starts with 11.0, for 2014 12.0, for 2016 13.0, for 2017 14.0, for 2019 15.0. So 2019 15.0. So they just checked here and it is showing 15.0. So immediately they responded, okay, 15.0 means SQL Server 2019, right? So that's why you are able to tell the answer immediately, without checking the version at all. Okay, so 15.0, if you see 15.0 means here, that means it belongs to SQL Server 2019. If you see 13.0, which version, guys? 13.0, which version?
16.
16, SQL Server 2016. Okay, 8.0?
2000.
Okay, so very good. So by just looking these numbers, you have to remember, guys, very important, how you remembered your SQL Server versions and Windows Server versions and compatibility. And again, this is also one more thing that should be on the tip of your tongue. Nothing, just 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Only for 2008 R2, 10.50 will be there. That's it. Nothing to remember. It's in a serial order. Okay, so 8.0, 9.0, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15.0. Next, if any new version is coming, it will be 16.0. So like this it will be. Fine. So tomorrow I'll ask the bill numbers. Okay. Just I'll ask, like, what is the bill number, how it is going to start for SQL Server 2017. You have to answer 14.0. Okay. So tomorrow I'll ask you the bill numbers, guys. Very important. Very, very important. By just looking the bill numbers, you are able to tell the version of the SQL Server. And third part is like an actual bill number. It will be changed if you updated or if you patch your SQL Server. If you patch the SQL Server, the third part and fourth part are going to change. Third part, fourth part are going to change if you just updated your SQL Server. Okay, with RTM copy, you will get one number. If you just patched your RTM copy, then you are going to like see the different numbers only in the third part and fourth part. First and second, not, they are not going to change. Okay. If you patch it also, they are not going to change. But if you patch the SQL Server, this third part and fourth part are going to change. Okay, I'll show you patching and all how to do. So everything we are going to discuss. Right, clear guys, everyone? Okay, so what is the build number for 11.0? Which version it belongs to, 11.0?
2012, sir.
12, very good, excellent, 2012. Okay, you can see here, 2012, which is 11.0. And again, okay. So what is this numbers, guys? Can anyone tell me? 8.0, 80. There is no dot here. Here dot is there. Here there is no dot. 9.0, 90. 10.0, 100. 10.50, okay, 100. 11.0, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150. What are these numbers, guys? These numbers are called binaries. Okay, binaries. What is meant by binaries? When you install SQL Server 2019 in your laptop, one folder will be created with the name of 150. When you install SQL Server 2012 in your laptop or server, one folder will be created with the name of 110. If you want to see, let me show you. Okay, see where you can see those things. See, okay, C drive, program files, Microsoft SQL Server, instance root directory. Yeah, here this is fine. See here, 80, 90, 110, 130, 140, 150 folders. Okay, if you install SQL Server, if you install highest version of the SQL Server, you can see the lower version of folders also. All the lower version features will be there in the binaries folders, lower version binaries. Okay, so you can see here, right? You can see 80, 90. Don't think if you can see 80 means don't think SQL Server 2000 is installed in this machine. No, even though you install higher version, lower version folders you can see. Okay, fine. So you can see 140, 130, 110, 90, 80. So these are the lower version binaries. So lower version binaries also will come. Okay, so if you see here, 8.0, if you install 2000 in your machine, 80 folder will be created. If you install 2005, 90 folder will be created. 2008, 100 folder will be created. 2008 R2 also 100 only, not 105. Okay, 2012, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150 folders are going to be created if you install the SQL Server, SQL servers. Okay, fine, clear guys, about the build numbers, binaries. Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's fine. So let's jump into one more small topic that is called editions of the SQL Server. Editions and components, we'll discuss these two things. And Monday onwards, we'll start creating virtual machines. We'll install Windows operating systems and we'll start installing SQL servers and all, right?
Sir, so tell me, sir. Sir, in build number, there is a 2000.5. Can you explain 2000 and .5?
2000.5, I told you already, this 2000.5 is your actual build number and revision history. Okay, so this 2005 will help you to check whether your SQL Server is patched or not.
So what does it mean, sir, 2000?
2000 means it's a number.
Why only 2000? Why it is not 1000? Why it is not 500?
See here, why it is not 500, why that is a Microsoft standards. Okay, they will give one number. So if you give 500 again, you will ask why it is not 2000. Okay, so it's nothing like that. It's a Microsoft standard. They will give one standard number. Okay, for each and every patch. Imagine if you want to understand this properly. Okay, you have to attend the patching classes. Okay, so let me show you as you have already asked. Okay, here, SQL Server builds.blogspot.com. There you can see all the versions and the updates also. Fine. So 2019, the RTM, they released like this. They released the RTM like this. Okay, Microsoft released the RTM with this number itself. It's a standard number from the Microsoft. It reflects that is an RTM copy. 2000.5, you can see, right? RTM, under RTM, you can see 15.0, 2000.5, which reflects this is your RTM copy of the SQL Server. So you can directly tell whether, now tell me whether your SQL Server is patched or not by just looking 2000.5.
Not patched, sir.
Patched, sir.
Patched or not?
No, patched. Sir.
I need answers from not everyone. Patched. Whether your SQL Server is patched or not. Check here and tell me whether not your patched. SQL Server is patched or not.
Not patched, sir. As per
not
that.
Patched. Why not patched? By just looking this number, it is reflecting an RTM copy. If you see RTM for RTM 2000.5, it's a standard from Microsoft. That means you can clearly understand, okay, I can see 2000.5 means which is not patched. My SQL Server is not patched. If you patch with the latest update, this is latest update, cumulative update. Okay, see here, 15.0 will be same and your third number and fourth numbers are going to change.
Right,
4178. So if you ask me why, sir, 4178, why not 417273, they just gave a standard number for CU13. For this update, they gave number like 4178. Might okay, be there might sir. Be a different meaning, but 4178 might be there are the updates. Okay, there are the like bugs they found. I don't know what is that exact this one. Why they gave 4178, but what it is reflecting with which update they patched. Okay, it is reflecting that one. If you click on this one, you can see all the cumulative updates, all the updates. Okay, so if you see here, 4123, 4123, yeah. 4123 means what? CU10. Okay, if you just updated your SQL Server with the latest cumulative update, then your third number and fourth number are going to change 4178.1. Okay, so what is the 2000? Where is the 2? Yes, this is the one. This is the RTM copy. You can see which one is highlighted RTM. If you updated with a CU1 or GDR, this 2000 will be changed to 2070. Again, if you updated with another security update, it will be changed to 2080. And if you updated with CU1, it will be changed to 4013. So depends upon the updates, this number is going to change. And if you observe it, it is going to increase. Never this number is going to be decreased. In every occurrence, it will be increased only. So if you are applying more updates, the third and fourth number is keep increasing, keep increasing, keep increasing. Clear? Everyone, so third
yes,
part
sir.
And fourth part will reflect whether your SQL Server is patched or not. Okay, right, fine. So let's jump into the editions of the SQL Server. Editions, what is meant by edition of the SQL Server, where we are going to use, what are the editions of there, are there in the SQL Server, let's discuss. Edition means simply limitations to the features is called editions. Limitations to the features is called edition. So every batch, I'll give you one example, the matrimony example. Okay, so let's discuss the matrimony example. Let's open matrimony website, any matrimony website. Something like shadi.com. Huh? And today onwards, I'll get all shadi.com ads in my laptop. Even though I'm married. Okay, let's begin. I'm looking for, okay, of course I have to look. Okay, anything, that's fine. And select, that's fine. Let's begin, let's see. Mm-hmm. Profile, I have to create profile for self only. I have to give these many details. Okay, that's fine. Right, so let me explain. I hope everyone experienced these things. So let me explain. If you go to shadi.com or any matrimony website, usually, okay, you can see, initially you can create the account for free, no problem. Okay, they will ask basic details. They will allow us to create the accounts for free. Once you started creating the account, that's it. From that day onwards, from that minutes onwards, you will get a lot of matches. For boys, you will get the girls matches, and for girls, you will get boys matches and all. Photo, neat photo and all, you can see. Okay, and they are going to mention some basic details, name and all, location and all, they'll mention. If you click on that profile, again, it will ask you sign up, sign up, sign up. Okay, chalo, we'll sign up. Then there you can see three plans. One is basic plan, then silver plan, basic or silver plan, gold plan, platinum plan. What it means, guys? What is meant by silver plan, gold plan, and platinum plan?
Sir, it provide a facilities, sir. Depends facilities. Upon our plan.
Very good.
Yes.
Facilities. And simply, let me explain very simple. Okay, example. Internet. You all are using internet, right? So right. Broadband internet. So there are different plan. I am using ACT. So in the ACT also there are different plans. Okay, ACT Rapid, ACT Fibernet, ACT different plans are there. What it means simply, if I pay 800 rupees, I'll get 50 Mbps of speed, 500 GB of data, right? If I pay 1200, I'll get 75 Mbps and I'll get 700 or 750 GB of data. If I pay 2000, I'll get 100 Mbps and I'll get 1000 GB of data. So that means there are some features which are unlocked in each stage.
Right, sir.
Right? There are some features which are unlocked in each stage. That is called additions. Features will be there, but depends upon which feature you are going to use, which edition you choose, the features are going to be limited. Which edition you see, if you choose a silver plan, there is a difference between 1000 and 10,000, right? If you choose a silver plan with 1000 rupees, you will get a basic details. Name you will get, location you will get, might be monthly you will get 10 or 15 profiles, right? And if you go for gold plan, same thing, extra you will get horoscope, okay? And extra you will get details, address might be, phone number might be. And if you go for a platinum plan, unlimited till you marry. The same features, but they are unlocked in each stage. In the same way, we have additions also. Okay, features will be there. They are going to be like, not locked actually, depends upon the feature, depends upon the addition. Okay, depends upon the additions. You can use the features of the existing SQL server. Okay, so we have different editions like gold plan, silver plan, platinum plan. In the same way, we have different editions in the SQL server. Evaluation edition, like a basic account. Basic account, what you can do, guys? Just you can see the photos. What else we can do? Right? So evaluation edition, express edition, mainly express edition, which is free edition, but there are a lot of limitations. There are a lot of limitations. Okay, the maximum database size in the Express Edition is 10 GB only. You cannot create any database more than 10 GB in the Express Edition. Okay, and there is no SQL Server agent. You can see right here, SQL Server agent, which is helpful for monitoring the jobs, creating the jobs, running the jobs and all. Backups, everything, okay, you can do with the help of this agent. But if the agent is not there, how can you automate the things in the SQL server? In the Express Edition, you don't see the agent.
Right.
Okay, so the features are going to be locked. Okay, so we have different editions. Mainly, these are the important editions. Express Edition, which is a free edition, but there are a lot of limitations are there. Evaluation Edition, okay, which is free for 180 days, 6 months. After that, again, you have to reinstall or else you have to go for any other edition or else like you have. These are the main editions, guys. These three are main editions. Standard edition, developer edition, and your enterprise edition. Standard, developer, and your enterprise edition. Let me remove this and let me, place it here. And this is the hierarchy, okay? So developer edition, standard edition, and enterprise edition. So up to SQL Server 2016, developer edition is like you have to pay the money. It's not free. Up to SQL Server 2016, even for developer edition also, you have to pay the money. But from SQL Server 2017 onwards, developer edition is also free. All features are there in the developer edition. All features are there. In the developer edition, all features are there and this is free. But again, you cannot install this in the production environment as discussed. Remember, guys, you cannot install any free editions in the production environment, but you can install paid editions in any environment. If you install free editions in the production environment, Microsoft is going to lose money. If you install paid editions in any environment, Microsoft is going to get the money. So which one will choose? Even if you are Microsoft boss, which one you'll choose? You'll get money or you're going to lose the money?
Lose the money.
Lose the money, huh? Then you right. Close the Microsoft.
they are providing a free version, then they will lose money.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Free versions, free editions, you cannot install on a production environment. Okay, that's illegal. You have to pay right. Fine for that. Microsoft right. Will perform audits in the organization. They will check what and all editions, what and all versions, how many SQL servers you are using. They will generate a report, complete report. So if you are using a free edition in the production environment, they will give you fines. Okay, might be 2 times, 3 times of your licensing cost. Okay, so you cannot install a free edition in the production environment. At the same time, you can install paid editions in any environment. You can install enterprise edition also in the test environment. Why? Because Microsoft is getting money, so it won't stop you.
Right.
Okay, so like this. So especially, okay, developer edition, we are going to install on non-prod environments like test environment, stage environment, developer environments. Okay, non-prod environments, we can use developer edition. And standard edition and enterprise edition, you can install on your production environment. Okay. So again, there are no big differences are there. All features will work in all these three editions, but might be some difference. Please mute it. Who is that?
Sir, some disturbance is coming. Can you mute from your side, sir?
Let me mute it. Okay, fine. Please guys, please mute it in case if you don't have questions. Okay, right, fine. So, yes, developer edition, standard edition, enterprise edition, there is no big difference in features wise. All features will work. Might be there is a difference in database size and all, but in developer edition also you can create a big databases and all, not a small. If you still wants to see the differences between developer edition, standard edition, enterprise edition, just go to the Google and go to the Microsoft website and check what are the, why? Because no one will ask you what is the difference between developer standard and enterprise edition and all. The one difference is a developer you cannot install on production environment, whereas other editions you can install on any environment and of course on production environment. Okay, you can either install enterprise or standard editions. Enterprise edition is the highest edition, guys. Enterprise edition is the highest edition, which is very costly, and you have to install, usually in the organization will install this enterprise edition on the production environment only, but by mistake sometimes people will install enterprise edition in the non-prod also. Okay, but that is not good. If you see any enterprise edition in the non-prod environment, okay, tell to your manager or team lead, okay, these many enterprise editions we are using on non-prod environment, we are paying a lot of money, so we'll go with the developer edition which is free. So that is like impressive work. Okay, so that is an impressive work. So you can use enterprise edition in the non-prod environments also, but again, you are going to pay the money for a free product. Okay, so you can use developer editions on non-prod, and enterprise edition is too costly, and we usually use it on your production environments. Clear, guys? Any issues, any doubts as of now? And up to SQL Server 2016, your developer edition is not free. From 2017 onwards, your developer edition is free. Okay? 2017 onwards, you can use your 2017 developer edition, and 2019 developer edition also, you can install it on your non-prod environments and you can use it. Lot of features are there in the developer editions also. Clear? Any issues, any doubts? Okay, so let me close the meeting. Let me reopen the meeting, guys. The meeting is showing less than 1 minute. We'll discuss components, then we'll close the session. Okay, let me reopen the meeting. Please join immediately with the same link.